It's Grand Ole Opry time, starring Red Foley.
Haven't got to worry, haven't got to care, haven't got a thing to call my own. Though I'm out of money, I'm a millionaire, I still have my home in San Antonio. When I greet my neighbor with a "how you all," I'm wealthy as a king upon a throne. You can have your mansion or a cottage small, I'll just take my home in San Antonio. Country on my merry way, then in crowds and felt I was alone. When I feel like bragging, I just up and say, I'm a native son of San Antonio. There's a sweet somebody by the Alamo, someday she's gonna be my very own. Then we'll get a high chair in a year or so for our little home in San Antonio. I'll just take my home in San Antonio. Yes, sir. Well, thanks a lot, and a good big howdy to all of my good friends and neighbors of Grand Ole Opry.
This is the biggest night of the year for us here in Nashville, Red. For tonight, we celebrate the 25th anniversary of the Grand Ole Opry. And what a lineup we've assembled to help us with the occasion. The Dinning Sisters, Uncle Dave Macon, Judge George D. Hay, the Possum Hunters, Rod Brasfield, the Jordanaires, and the entire cast of Grand Ole Opry Boys and Girls.
Yes, sir, Grant, and a little later on in the program, we're going to be privileged to hear from the Honorable Gordon Browning, Governor of Tennessee. I think, if I'm not mistaken, that we're going to also hear from Minnie Pearl, who is rapidly recovering here in Nashville. So it looks like a night to be long remembered. And here are the Jordanaires Quartet to help get things going fast and furious. Boys, let's have that one called Lead Me to That Rock.
Don't you lead me to that rock that is higher than thou? Oh, lead me, yes, lead me. Why don't you lead me to that rock that is higher than I? Thou hast been a shelter for me.
Well, when you go down to yonder fold and search among the sheep,
my brother, thou hast been a shelter for me.
Well, you'll find him there, so I've been told, that though he loves you,
my brother, thou hast been a shelter for me. Why don't you lead me to that rock that is higher than thou? Oh, lead me, yes, lead me. Why don't you lead me to that rock that is higher than I? Thou hast been a shelter for me.
Why don't you lead me to the rock that is higher than I?
The rock
that is higher than I. You lead me to the rock
that is higher than I. Thou hast been a shelter for me.
Why don't you
lead me to the rock that is higher than I?
There's a right smart young fellow back here that's been busting at the leash there in the wings, I think, and it don't look like we can hold him much longer. Folks, the Hohenwald Flash himself, One of America's funniest men right here, Rod Bracefield. Come out here, Rod.
Thank you, man.
Well, to Rod, right now I think that we should report on the progress of the gossip of Grinder Switch, Cousin Minnie Pearl. You know, she's doing just fine when Rod and me went out to Vanderbilt Hospital the other day to visit her, wasn't she?
Yes, sir, Mr. Foley. I know our Minnie's feeling better because she told me a man took some X-ray pictures of her, and she says that it was sure fun to find a man who could really see something in her.
All right. Rod, ain't that...
Don't that sound like me?
Yeah. Ain't that a modern hospital Minnie's in out there, though?
Modern? That hospital is so up to date, they've got cures that ain't even found diseases for her yet.
Oh, wait a minute. You sure you're telling the truth, Rod?
Well, sure. As my gal Susie once said when she bought a size 32 girdle, maybe I am stretching things a little bit.
Well, while we're on the subject, Rod, I wish you wouldn't bother with the... Listen to me, will you? I wish you wouldn't bother with that pretty nurse when we go out there to visit Minnie.
Why, Slitter, Mr. Foley, all I done was ask her to take my temperature.
Rod, wait a minute. You knew very well that you didn't have any fever.
Nah, I know that, Mr. Foley, but it wouldn't have taken much time for her to give me one.
Well, to get back to Minnie, did she like that present you brought for her, Rod?
She sure did like it, Mr. Foley.
It sure was a nice gift, yes, sir. Beautiful. A nightgown trimmed in feathers.
Trimmed in feathers?
Yes, sir.
She was just tickled to death with it. Mr. Foley, I ain't one to go around spreading rumors, you know, and gossiping and talking. But I heard a thing a while ago about old Grant Turner that is absolutely so scandalous, I just can't hold it back.
Well,
I've got
hear
to
it.
Tell you about
let's
it.
Hear it.
Do you know that he beats his wife up every morning?
Oh, Rod, now wait a minute. I can't believe that. A nice fellow like Grant Turner would beat his wife up every morning?
Yeah, he does.
Oh, Rod.
She stays in bed till 8 o'clock and he gets up at 7. Oh. Get a good one like that almost, you, Mr. Foley. Howdy, friends. Bind that, it ain't hot tonight, is it?
It's a little chilly, ain't it, Rod?
Hi, mister.
You know what, Rod, I'll admit that you're mighty smart, yes, sir. But you know something? If your Uncle Sipe had been as smart as you, he wouldn't have got such an awful strain last week.
Uncle Sipe got a strain?
Yes,
how
sir.
Did he get a strain?
Drinking soup through his mustache.
Just kills me to get a good and all rod like that.
That makes me so mad I could eat a snow burger or something. I'm telling you that. Mr. Foley, the other night, me and M.J. Russian was a possum hunting, see, down there in Russian's Creek.
Yeah.
And we went out there possum hunting, and we caught two or three possums, and it was about 4 o'clock in the morning, and it's cold. Oh, it's so cold, the old hens was laying from a standing position, you know what I mean? Well, sir, we come in home, and we went to bed. Me and MJ went to bed, and the first thing I knowed, we had the cover pulled up, and I noticed his feet sticking out from under the cover. I says, MJ, what in the cat hair have you got your feet stuck out from under the cover for? He says, well, Rod, I'd be a darn fool to take them cold things in bed with me.
Well, I think it's about a year ago, we had three mighty pretty young ladies come down from Chicago to pay us a visit here. You folks have heard them on records. You've heard them on the air and on television. You've probably seen them on the stage and in the movies. So let's give a great big welcome to three mighty pretty young ladies, the Denning Sisters. Yes, sir.
I got you right in here between you pretty girls, huh?
Oh.
Well, sir, girls, I know it'll be kind of tough for all three of you to talk at once, so we'll just skip all the palaver and get to your singing, which is
Easy for all three of you to do it once. What are you going to sing for us, huh?
Tennessee Waltz.
Well, they talk together, don't they? Here we go.
I was dancing with my darling to the Tennessee Waltz when an old friend I happened to see. I introduced her to my loved one, and while they were dancing, my friend stole my sweetheart from me. I remember the night and the Tennessee Waltz. Now I know just how much I have lost. Yes, I lost my little darling the night they were playing the beautiful Tennessee Waltz. I remember the night and the Tennessee Waltz. Now I know just how much I have lost. Yes, I lost my little darling the night they were playing the beautiful Tennessee
Friends, if you were listening to WSM on your crystal sets one cool night about a quarter of a century ago, chances are you heard music such as being picked and fiddled in the background there. And this music would have been played by the same bunch of old-timers that are playing it now. Grand Opry's famous Possum Hunters. Yes, sir, there they are. Play that good news. Yesterday was the Possum Hunters, and the boys are still going strong. Now, getting back to that night in November 1925, if you were tuned in, you heard a mighty familiar toot on an old steamboat whistle and a mighty friendly voice talking to you, sort of like this.
This is the solemn old judge, George D. Hay. Thank you, neighbors. You have been listening to Dr. Walter Damreisch and his orchestra presenting music in the Grand Opera manner. From now on, our program, in contrast, will be known as the Grand Ole Opry. Page, Uncle Dave Macon, accompanied by his son Doris, singing an old favorite, Chewing Gum. Okay, Uncle Dave.
Sing you about my pretty little girl. She just as pretty as a plum. Happy she had was one night was bad. She was always a chewing gum. Whenever she came to Sunday school, she
always come with a chum. Oh, right where they sat and right where they sat, they were both a chewing gum. Yum, yum. She's so neat and she looks so sweet. Her silks and her hats were so plum. Wherever she went, oh, she spent every cent for chewing gum, yum, yum. Walked out of town, she always did look so cute. Every merchant she knocked for, she called for a box of juice, juice, juice.
Well, so thank you, Uncle Dave Macon, and that's how it was 25 years ago. Judge Hay, we sure do want to thank you for making honest folks out of us and giving this show a name.
Thank you, Red Foley. The Opry will always be my special baby, and I'm proud to be connected with it.
Well, Judge, thanks a lot to you. The governor of Tennessee, the Honorable Gordon Brownon, had planned to be here with us tonight, but business in Knoxville has kept him from joining us. However, he called me during the past week and... he asked me to present the Grand Ole Opry with a special plaque in his behalf, and he wants you to have it, Judge. Here it is, and congratulations to you.
Thank you very, very much, Governor Gordon Browning.
Judge, would you mind reading that inscription on the plaque there, please?
Certainly, Red. It reads, Grand Ole Opry, 25 years. The world's greatest single contribution to American folk music. Signed, Gordon Browning, Governor of Tennessee. Thank you so much, Governor Gordon Browning.
Now, the next voice you hear will be the Honorable Gordon Browning, Governor of Tennessee.
Not so long ago, a friend of mine told me of an experience he had over in the European theater during the last war. He's a native Tennessean and extremely proud of his state, as he should be. Moreover, he's more than willing to engage the ear of anyone who will listen to him about the advantages of living in the volunteer state. Well, on this occasion, he and his outfit were pinned down by enemy fire near St. Lo. And my friend, the first lieutenant, found himself sharing a foxhole with a tall, gangling foot soldier of about 20 or 22. It looked like a long, tedious wait, so the lieutenant proceeded to pass the time by making a speech on his favorite subject, the state of Tennessee. No man was ever more eloquent before an audience of one, and my lieutenant friend reached oratorical heights never before scaled as he told of the climate, the natural beauties of Tennessee, its great colleges and universities, its agriculture, its commerce, its exciting early history, its great TVA system of dams, and its historic state capital, Nashville. Finally, after about an hour and 40 minutes, the lieutenant paused for breath and said, "Soldier, are there any questions?" And the private said, "Yes, sir. How do I go about getting a picture of Minnie Pearl?" My purpose in relating this anecdote is to illustrate the fame WSM's Grand Ole Opry has brought to the state of Tennessee. As governor of the state, it's my sincere pleasure to salute the talented and hard-working entertainers who have made the Opry a national institution these past 25 years. To Red, Rod, Minnie, and everyone connected with the Grand Ole Opry, congratulations. And the heartfelt appreciation of the state of Tennessee.
Thank you very much, Gordon Browning. And now, that sort of brings us to our very lovely guest for this special anniversary show, the three Denning sisters. Girls, I see you're already out here. I think you got a sort of a special arrangement on an old tune called Old Mona, haven't you?
That's right.
Huh?
Yeah,
let's hear it. Here we go.
Do-da, 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 do-da. Da-da, da-da, da. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
Once upon a time, a country preacher sitting on a log. Oh, Mona, had his finger on the trigger and his eye on a hog. Oh, Mona, the gun went boom and the hog said yip. Oh, Mona, the preacher grabbed him with all his grip. Oh, Mona, you shall be free. Oh, Mona, you shall be free. When the good Lord set you free. What part of time I was gliding down the road. Oh, Mona, had a tired team and a heavy load. Oh, Mona, I popped my whip and the lead horse sprung. Oh, Mona, the hind horse busted the wagon tongue. Oh, Mona, oh, Mona, you shall be free. Oh, Mona, you shall be free. When the good Lord set you free. Once upon a time by the hen house on my knees. Oh, Mona, I thought I heard a chicken sneeze. Oh, Mona, he sneezed so hard with a whooping cough. Oh, Mona, he sneezed till his head and his tail flew off. Oh, Mona, oh, Mona, you shall be free. Oh, Mona, you shall be free. When the good Lord sets you free. Do-da, 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 do-da. Da-da, da-da, da. Don't you worry, Mona, 'cause you shall be free. Shall be free.
Two weeks have had a big hunk of happiness taken out of our show by the absence of one of the Opry's charter members. So tonight, we thought we'd get firsthand an anniversary greeting from one of the most beloved and most popular gals in the entertainment world by paying a little visit to her bedside. And here she is, the gossip of Grinder Switch, Cousin Minnie Pearl.
Proud to be here. Well, sir, I sure wished I could be down there tonight in person to see all of y'all and just help celebrate that silver jubilee. You know, I've been there 10 of the 25 years. Come up there just a slip of a girl. I've been a slipping fast ever since. And that reminds me, you know what happened when I was in that hospital? Somebody got mixed up and sent me one of them there face doctors that tries to help you look beautiful. Like I'd need that. Well, it is almost worth though being poly to get all them fine cards and letters I got. Oh, it was so nice. Letters and cards all the way from Oregon to Florida. Well, sir, I'm awful anxious to get well so I can run down to the Switch next week and get all the latest news. Oh, been more happening down there. I know it. Uncle Nabob said it's been so cold down there, he's just afeard to pet the dog for fear he'd wag his tail and it'd fall off so stiff. Well, sir, I got to be a-going now, and I'll see y'all next week, straight from the Switch. Bye now.
Thanks a lot to you, Minnie Pearl. We'll be looking for you back with us next Saturday. Yes, sirree, bye. My heart is sad and I'm lonely, thinking of the one I love. I know that I shall ne'er more see her till we meet in heaven above. They told me that she loved another. How could I believe their
till an angel softly whispered, she has proven untrue to you.
The United States Armed Forces Radio Service, the voice of information and education.